Hey,
you get your hands off of it.
Anything to say, lady?
Well, I said...
You did.
Hey. Bill Cochran. Your man?
The same.
Yep, we're paying on him. Now then, Mr. Sartana, am I right?
The same.
What's your preference? Hundreds, huh?
Yeah, hundreds. Just hurry it up, will you?
Hmm. Bank policy is to identify body.
Go ahead.
Pay it out, feller. In tens, twenties, hundreds, and anything else you got. And make it fast. It's uncomfortable here.
All right, everyone, stay right where you are. Over against the wall, you two.
Delicate door.
They took along Simms' hostage. We go after him, he'll be a dead duck.
Who's feller in black?
Santana.
Yeah? If it's bank in the West, that bank director ought to fire himself. Like old rabbit the way he run off out of there. So you don't reckon we went and let him go a little too early? Now, it'd probably take 2 days to get back to town. Hmm? Oh, $300,000.
And $10,000's mine.
I sure got a hand.
Hey, Bill, let's divvy it up now.
Why don't you let Sartana decide that?
Jerry?
Yes, sir?
My pistol, the Colt. I'm going hunting. Nearly 5,000 I took from you. You can try and win it back if you want.
You cleaned me out.
Too bad. It's a real pleasure playing with you, seeing how you seem to lose every hand.
Would you give me credit on this? Just so you give me time to go out and collect it and come back once I lose it.
Take it easy. My head is splitting. What's gotten to those damn dogs?
I don't know, sir.
My rifle. Come on, give me the rifle.
Here. Come and get it.
Sartana.
That's right, Simms. This time it is me.
What do you want from me? I mean, haven't you done enough? If you're after more money, there's none here, but I can get it for you if you want. Is that what you want, Sartana?
No. I want to hear your version of what happened the other day. You recognized me according to the papers.
But it was you. Your cloak. Your hat.
Simms. Like that, anyone could pass a Sartana.
Are you sure that train pulled in at 10 o'clock, Corporal?
Sure, I'm sure.
And you're sure there's only one of them on it, huh?
Yeah, sure, I'm sure. And I'm even more sure ain't wetting whistle all day either. Here, give me that thing. Listen, you varmint. I'm hoping you ain't got a mind to do your killing right while I'm watching you. Because there are certain dirty doings the Honorable Mayor won't permit in the middle of the street.
Only I elected you mayor. Unanimous.
Ah, so you did.
Funny. He should be here by now.
You can't shirt it off.
Hey, Buddy Ben.
Sartana.
You're a mite nervous today. Were you expecting someone? Or were you aiming at me?
I've been waiting for a certain son of a bitch what got me in a little trouble.
I never knew you to be out of trouble, buddy.
Well, he will be. Leastwise, as long as I'm around to protect him.
I elected him mayor of this cemetery. Unanimous. It's always smart to have a place to get away to for a while. Know what I mean?
Afternoon, Your Honor.
How do you call him corporal?
By the way, what's this I hear about your going after banks?
Now, that happens to be the reason I was looking for you, Buddy Ben.
So they both got out of jail.
Maybe you're seeing double, Buddy Ben. Double. Must be that. Double, yeah.
Can I help you out?
Nah, these buzzards is mine.
Suit yourself.
Real glad to see you, Buddy Ben.
I'm real glad to see you boys again, too. I've been hoping you'd come around.
You got another of your fancy jobs for us?
More or less. Hey, Mayor, what's the matter, huh? Can't you count? Seeing double, huh? Hey, you crazy?
To get back to what I'm here for, I don't appreciate having my name being used to fool around.
If you're talking about the Northwestern Bank robbery, shoot, I was in jail. That's why I killed those two buzzards just now. They put me there. And naturally, I escaped. Only I was too late.
I'll take your word for it. It's a pretty powerful alibi you've got going.
Hey, listen, Sartana. How about letting me go along with you? Now, if you want to catch a thief, you need a thief. And I'm the best there is. And with that price on your head, I could come in right handy.
Hey, you better stay here, buddy.
Hold on, Sartana. I have a little piece of information that I want to tell you as you're my friend. That pretty colored smoke they say the gang was using. Now, I'd say that sounds a bit like a professional job. Sounds a bit like Dynamite Butch. Without naming no names.
That's an idea. Thanks a lot, buddy. So long.
What? He don't have the $300,000 that they took from the Northwestern?
Not at the moment, Mayor. Not at the moment.
Thank you.
You're one hell of a lousy amigo to come after me like that.
Nothing personal, Sartana. Saw your beautiful money, Chico. Had to put my hands on it.
You were real smart to find me.
It was very easy. Bill Cockard, your partner, was captured nearby. In hot iron.
Don't talk now, Shadow. We gotta get you to somebody who can sew you back together again.
No, amigo. I'm dead. Your bullet never... this side.
Well, Sartana, I see you got here a mite too late. So old Butch hung himself.
Yeah, only somebody helped him with it. Got quite a piece of news to tell you. It's gonna make you real happy.
Tell it.
The Lawbirds caught Bill Cochran.
Ain't that a coincidence? Because that's the reason I came here to tell you.
Another old partner of yours?
Well, not exactly. Me and him and Butch, we just done a few little jobs together.
If it interests you, I think I'll talk to Cochran.
Oh, I wouldn't say that I'm interested. Only out of friendship. You know, if a man's got just one friend, he's got himself a real treasure.
Played poker with him often enough.
Then why aren't you out there capturing him?
Shit. Looks to me like there's enough dogs fighting over the same bone.
Mind if I join the game? Please, why don't you all take your seats?
Hey! Hey! You're missing the show!
Gentlemen.
Dynamite Butch!
I understand that you run the Hot Iron Courier. I want to have a few words with you.
The betting opens up at $20 and ain't no limits.
Hey, guess what? That man out there, he ain't Sartana. He's a dead corpse. Hey, are you all gone deaf? I said that ain't Sartana out there.
You keep your faces behind the bar. Just see to the drinks and have me worry about sending for the sheriff. I want a new deck, if you don't mind, gentlemen.
New deck!
Yeah.
Well then, where were we? I was on the verge of a question.
What is it you want to know?
The other evening, they brought in Bill Cochran. Young fellow?
Yeah, it's true they did. My newspaper published a feature on it.
And where's our feature now?
I have a copy right here.
I was referring to Bill Cochran.
Ah, Bill Cochran. He's in jail, right here, in Hot Iron.
I'll open with $20. Two cards.
I'll take two.
Three.
What I've got to do. Is our feature hurt?
Well, not seriously. He's under guard, but I'm afraid the sheriff... The sheriff and the others are out looking for you, Sartana.
Sartana? Never trust appearances, gentlemen. You may now run out and bring in the sheriff. Shall we get on with the game?
$100.
I'll stay. Raise you 100.
I'll raise you 1,000. Pass, Joe.
I ain't calling. What have you got?
Four ladies.
Hold it. This deck has... five queens, because I have a straight flush, king high. I'm sorry, gentlemen, but I've got to go. I have a prisoner waiting for me.
Hey, Sartana, you ain't just gonna walk out because somebody here was cheating.
And I bet you're that somebody.
The only queen I pull is the queen of spades.
We got a real high gallows on the edge of town, boy, and that's the end of your line.
You'll find I've got a real long line, Sheriff. Wake up.
Listen, Sartana. I'll trick just as bad as you was. The moment we started divvying up the money, that some bitch killed everyone. We was all tricked, Sartana.
Go on, name the son of a bitch, Cochran. His name, Cochran.
I tell you his name, Promiser Wood. Well, I'm afraid you'd just leave me here to the ropes, so let me out of here, and I'll take you to him. All right?
To him where?
Boker Falls.
Good evening, Sheriff. I didn't kill this one. Go ahead and smell it. Buddy Ben, what are you doing up there?
Waiting for you, boy, to give you a hand.
What for?
Shall we say half the reward?
No. I want that $10,000 all for myself. I'm a pig.
Well, a pig? But $5,000 is better off by a long mile than one with... that one without a cent.
Why? Why, I bet you'll try to cheat me out of it all. 10 to 1.
Okay, you're on. You know what? Your betting's gonna be the ruin of you someday, hot dad.
I like the game. Let's go. Who's first, hmm? Heads or tails?
Heads.
Heck, you win. Buddy Ben. The son of a bitch, he won my $10.
Now you killed a prisoner and you let that bastard Satana go. So we'll just hang you instead.
Drop your gun, Bill. Come on now.
Down your toys. Ollie, come on, drop them. The ones in the holsters, too. That's good, boys. I'm proud of you all. Listen, boys, I'm going to my horse. And you all stay put. Or I'll plug up his ears. Told you all to stay put. We haven't stopped all day, Sheriff. What are you running away from, anyhow?
Shut up and ride, Satana. That bullet was meant for your head, not Cochran's. Think of it as a favor I'm doing you by taking you away. You free all them bounty hounds. You just get a fair trial and be hanged.
Mamacita, senores. If you want good food, this is the place for you, huh? I got frijoles in oil, frijoles with peppers, or frijoles with pork fat. How do you want them, senores?
In silence, if you don't mind, Mamacita.
Sort of impolite, eating with handcuffs on.
No, sorry, friend. Not before we get there.
Going a bit far?
Yeah, well, maybe we are, but you never can tell who might get greedy for that reward. Or a share of that $300,000.
Here are your frijoles.
What's the matter with you? Are you afraid the silence will make you fall asleep? That'd be nice for you, huh? Don't worry, I'll leave you one way or another. Not that I mind your company, but I have to go south. Your name don't frighten me. Pretty good with those cards.
Thanks. I can do even better.
Yeah?
Sit down. All right, now. Watch real closely, hmm? And here they are. Like to be able to do that little trick?
Yeah.
I'll teach you. Here. Now, shuffle them. Come on, faster than that.
Ah, much faster.
Not bad for a start. Now, hold out your palm and lay them on it. Don't look at your palm, look at my face. Now, look at the palm of your hand. Oh, no, don't take it badly. Anyway, you'd never have been much good.
It's going on.
It's Valentine's Day.
sleeping in a chair is so uncomfortable, senor. I have a nice soft bed. In the morning, I could bring you breakfast there.
I only drink coffee in the mornings, and I'm an early riser. Three queens.
Full house. You want to keep playing?
You cleaned me out.
That's all I had left. $30. Two cards.
I'll stay with you. And I'll take two myself.
$500.
What, $500? You've only got 30. Sorry, mister. well, if you've got a reserve, then.
Is this covered? Wake up, baby, or I'll kill your friend. Come on.
Jim!
What a nice young couple.
Look, please. I'll pay you if you don't hurt him. Anything, just
don't worry. I don't hurt anybody when I shoot. They die right away.
Don't, please. Jim, give him the money. All of it. Everything. Hurry!
You and the old fella change places. I always keep an empty. Gives me time to think. I'm somewhat impulsive. Load them on top. They're worth $1,500 each.
Okay, mister.
Marvelous work. Extremely impressive work. I need the cash for our poker game. But don't cheat. I'll lose anyway.
Time for the service, boss. 20 black ones.
room. Say your books.
You come into the service, Mark. They're about to start. Gosh.
Time to go to church.
Quiet down. I said quiet down. Quiet, everyone. You hear? Now then, gents, this here duel is legal. Because I'm the sheriff. Quiet. Now you all know the rules. You draw when I say. Anyone shoots before that, I'll even the odds.
Okay, Whistle. You still say the tables are rigged in my hall?
I'll save your breath, Baxter. I got no intentions of letting you lighten my pockets no longer. Neither you nor your dirty dealers.
Okay, you made your point. All right, everyone, you can place your bets now.
Over here, Josh. $30 on Baxter Red.
Here's $10 on Baxter Red.
Here's $10 on the stranger.
Extra it. Stranger, $10.
Hold on, Baxter. Baxter into it. $20.
Baxter Red.
Ain't you gonna wager? And what the hell are you doing here anyway? On Baxter Red?
All right, that's all. That's it. Now quiet down. The duel will now start. Take your places. Get ready. All set. Go!
You bastard, you cheated again.
Here's your one. You want Tim?
Here. Somebody get rid of the body. Let's have another two of you up.
Pair of your dice, Homer. The good ones, huh? I say the good ones.
$100.
But that's all I have.
You're a thief.
Greetings, Homer Crown. It seems that the joker who pulled that bank hold up lost something very similar to the cylinder, my pistol.
The only man there is who could make a twin of this is you, Homer Crown.
I've had a lot of requests to make those things.
There are a lot of these around, eh? Then who has one?
Well, that's a business secret.
I'm gonna aim this at your heart, Homer Crown.
I've sold a lot of those things to Baxter Redd, proprietor of the gambling hall, to several strangers that was just riding through. It's the truth, Sartana.
I really ought to pin you up to the wall. But I'll leave it until I'm sure you've been telling me the truth. My guest. Good luck.
Who's he?
Like the picture? I own this place. The name's Baxter Redd. You were an artist?
In my own way. She was your mother.
No, my wife. She fell for the painter, and I put 5 shots in each one.
Pop art.
You want to play a little poker?
No, I think I'll just watch a little. If you don't mind.
You're free to do what you want here.
Ten on that. 20. 20 on 13.
Ladies and gentlemen, are you bet.
Last call for laying your bets, ladies and gentlemen.
Do you mind if I play next to you, honey?
Yes, of course I mind.
That's it for this round, ladies and gentlemen. No more bets. No more bets. Red. Odd.
Look at that, will you? Well, I ain't one hand at this damn table in about 4 months.
You know, you're the kind of man I like. Honest. You see, my pa, yeah, read the Bible a lot.
Well, he didn't read it all, or he would have named you Salome.
I think you'll bring me lots of luck, honey.
Got the cackle and lay your bets.
Aren't now. You going to go? Mm-hmm.
Last call for bets, ladies and gentlemen. That's it for now. No more bets.
What's going on here?
His boots are pinching, so it appears.
Pay with the house, Ozen. With the regrets of the house.
By the way, folks, fun's over. I say we're deployed. Yeah, clear the way there, will you?
Go on with the game, please.
Sir, out of the way, please.
Hey, what is this, anyway? The winning number there. I bet on that number, too, you know?
No, you didn't bet on it.
But I...
Ah!
flea hound. Get out of here and take your fleas.
Just a moment now. I only wanted to warn you fellas.
Down that Sartana would never get to Poker Falls.
Someone around must have talked, but I got nothing to do with it, nothing.
Oh, yeah, Homer Crown, you do. You got a lot to do with it, like orders to get rid of Sartana.
Got any clean rooms in this hole?
What do you mean, sir? In this hotel, all rooms cleaner than whistle. Suite 16, sir. $2. In advance, please. Please. Vincent, help our guest to his room.
All right, Ping. Clean up this mess, Ping. You ought to feel ashamed for advertising you had clean rooms in this place.
Oh, yes.
What am I going to tell your mother? Yeah?
Don't shoot, it's the sheriff. Don't pay no attention to this. It's for show, that's all.
I can see that.
How come you knew this man was waiting just to put a bullet in you? The only clue was a hotel register. But did you ever know of a bounty hunter that's so damn foolish he'd write his true name down?
Watkins wasn't a fool. He happened to be left-handed, only he wrote his name in a register with his right.
Hmm.
They're right when they say you're one of the most suspicious men around. But here in Poker Falls, most of those that got no suspicions are dead. Allow me to welcome you officially to our city.
And sheriffs? The real ones, you understand. Any of them ever drop around?
Dozens. They come here to expire. Of course, you may stay if you pay and be quiet. Don't trip on any toes, though. Because they're all snakes, Sartana. A crummy crew, including actually me. Even though I'm the only one without a cent. It's because of that they call me a louse.
It's the same thing pretty much everywhere. If you're a rich louse, you're wealthy. If you're a poor louse, then you're nothing but a louse. By the way, talking about lice, you wouldn't have any idea of what brought a friend of mine by the name of Cochran here, would you?
Bill Cochran? I know, if I recall right, he worked as a bouncer at the amusement park. Yeah, I worked for the judge. Here in Poker Falls, the meanest ones always work for the judge. What the? What's it doing here?
When is your run stretch all the way here to Poker Falls?
Since today. That there fella riding inside's the one that did it.
It all to them?
Yeah, I told him we wanted Bandit on to shoot fast and hit hard to help me out.
Well, let's see what we got. Got all day, Clem. All right, mister. Just how fast can you pull a gun?
I'm alive.
Smart one, huh? Well, you all brag your heads off till it comes down to meeting it face to face. So, who the blazes are you?
I figured I was sort of popular around these parts. But it appears there are still some people who don't know me. This wad right here belongs to Bill Cochran. I know he used to work for you.
You must be the one who took the Northwestern Bank. Yeah, Bill Cochran worked for me as a bouncer a while back. But he disappeared, and I never heard from him again. I've no idea where he is. I can hold his money for you in case he contacts me. I'll be sure to give it to him the minute he shows up.
Unfortunately, I have an uneasy feeling Cochran won't show. But your friendly intentions are very much appreciated.
By the way, are there any friends Cochran might have had besides you here in Poker Falls?
How do you mean, friends? They don't exist here, mister.
Joe, come on, let's look.
You must have the very devil in your sight, Southanna. Yeah. Somehow you've always managed to save your skin. But I'm going to put an end to that right now. Raise your hands. Turn around. Now say your prayers to the devil.
Satana is mine. Not yet, Hot Dead.
I've come a long, hard way to find you and kill you, Satana. And I'm not about to let some two-bit tinker have you. Now let's see if you bring me luck, all right?
If I do, there's no need to kill me. If I don't, you're gonna die.
It's the logic of a scared man, Satana. Besides, threats excite me. I consider them a challenge. I want to clear something up with you.
Well, if there's something I can do for you, tell me.
It's about that outstanding debt.
Of course. You're talking about that poker game 5 years ago, right?
You see, Satana, those $5,000 have worried me, and rightly so, because I don't want people to say I killed you to Welsh on a debt.
I admire your integrity. Want to play a last hand with me? If you're the winner, we'll be even and we can shoot it out. If it's me, you'll be even deeper in debt.
Sure. Yeah, I like that. To beat. Ace wins. Three loses.
Now a man should live up to his integrity, in my opinion. I don't think you should have cheated like that.
I'm not a cheater. I was having fun.
I won. That'll be 10,000, please.
Here you are.
Were you so sure you could earn it?
I got pretty close, didn't I? You only won because I'm persecuted by misfortune.
Persecuted by misfortune? Come on now. I bet if you try hard enough, you'll end up a winner.
You broke me luck.
Twice in one day. Just now and before. When you lost.
We'll play another hand someday.
What is it you wanted to tell me?
If I tell you, you won't believe me.
Try me.
If I didn't know that you were Sartana, I'd swear that Sartana was on your trail. Somebody that dressed like you. And they say he looks just like you.
Might be. He's the one behind our holdup.
Why, that don't make sense, because if it was him, well, how come he's following you?
Come on now, think it over.
Oh, I get it. That if he kills you, he gets to keep the $300,000.
Introducing the sheriff.
I just heard I did kill Crown in the amusement park. Working for you, Sartana.
Now, whatever made you come around to ask that? Hey, Sheriff, are you weighing the odds whether or not it's worth it to join the hunt for, you know?
Whistle, tell Buddy.
Now, when a bounty hunter kills someone in town, it's my affair. You know, duties and all that.
Thank you.
The name is Death. And I want the man I take facing me, so turn...
You talking to me?
No, me.
Why did you want to kill me anyway?
Because you killed Slim Shotgun, my kid brother.
Sorry, but I never even set eyes on him.
Word of honor.
My word of honor.
That son of a bitch must have been lying. I should have killed him.
I was expecting a jealous husband and a dirty judge walks in. Hey, Sartana, look what I found wandering around.
Get out of here, Mr. Judge, and fast.
What'd you let him go for?
There's no need to look for what you've already got. Huh? Let's go. I want you to help me with something. You're sure that he's the one, are you?
Yep. Here's his pea shooter. Still in working condition.
Man could shoot a long way with this. Yep. He could put a bullet right through a jailhouse window.
What are you thinking about, Sartana?
Just that if Homer Crown had had the money, he would have laid low or let out. That's one down. Now, as for the judge, since he came around looking, it stands to reason he doesn't have the money either.
So what?
So what? So, that means you're gonna try your hand at roulette.
Roulette? You wanna talk now?
Please, please.
Come on, tell me. How come the boss here ain't Tracy Three Aces no more? Talk! Huh?
Tracy Three Aces was getting tired of it all. So a couple of weeks ago, when Baxter Red moved into town, Tracy forked over the whole operation for $150,000, sir.
Yeah, I guess Baxter Red is an awful rich man, huh? Well, thanks, my boy. I think I've had enough playing.
There you go, Sheriff. 30 of them. You're getting the same rate as Judas.
Hey, you know, this is one hell of a time to insult a fella. I ain't even got my boots on.
Oh, what's that for?
Why did you kill Slim Shotgun?
No. Todd, Doug, please stop it. Stop it.
Oh, we're having oil, Sheriff.
Red.
For dinner.
I pulled the trigger, but he paid me to do it.
Repeat what you just said.
He was Master Ed.
Fine. Now, I want you to go tell your friend that I'm challenging him to a duel. Tonight, according to the rules, at least in theory. By the way, how many men does he bring along to shoot his opponents in the back?
Well, usually two or three. Depends on who you are.
And you? Tell me whose side you're on.
I don't know yet. I'll side with the winner.
Hey, you.
Just a minute. You're not going with us?
Oh, this mess ain't mine.
Oh, yes, it is, Sheriff. You're in it. And it was you who got me in it.
Oh, it was your own greediness, Baxter. That's all that got you in the mess you're in. You should have been ready to take the consequences.
Give me your gun. A little nervous, Baxter Ed? Or don't you like Buddy's playing?
Yeah, it's only when he has to face it that he don't like music.
Oh, come on, huh? Kill me, will you?
I will, that's for sure. Only I want you to die yelling. Go on. Start yelling. Yell.
Ah!
More voice. Come on out of your hole, Louse. I know you're here. That's the first time this gentleman of the South has ever been slandered in such a regrettable manner. Negejo. Since when have you been here?
A while.
You've come for my scalp, I imagine.
That's right. I'll bet this will be the most famous gunfight in history. Don't you agree?
It could be a wrong move, Degeo. We're chips on the board, but we're not the one who spins the wheel.
I'm not interested in that. I'm not a gambler, Sartana. I'm a bounty hunter. And there's a price on your head. My kind of price.
All right, Degeo. Whenever you're ready.
Remember this?
It's as good as mine. You must have tried 10 times to give it to me for helping you kill Lassiter.
That was then. This is now. I'm keeping this in remembrance of you. It's time to go to hell, Sartana. When the clocks tick 10 seconds, you draw.
Adios.
One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten.
It's your turn. The game is over, buddy.
Well, you quite a brain, ain't you? You found me out. About time. Boy, I nearly burst up laughing holding up the bank. Didn't I was you. Imagine me. Sorry. Oh.
What else have you left out besides the painting? Tell me.
You must know more than me by now.
This was your gambling hall.
No. He got the place with his share of the money. It wasn't mine. I was nothing but his front man. Everybody would have been clear if it hadn't been for that Bill Cochran. If Whistle hadn't had to make sure he was dead, then you would have been able to figure out from Shotgun or that brother of his what Cochran didn't tell you. It's bad luck, Saul.
Bad luck all around. I thought I was going to get my hands on that $300,000. But instead, I guess I just have to be content with 10.
Bill!
begging your pardon, Your Honor, sir. I hate to bother you at this particular time, but... Well, I plumb forgot that today was Sunday and the banks was all closed. So I thought I'd bring my friend out here before he got a little too rancid with all that heat. A man's got to take care of his investments, ain't he? Hey, you should have seen it, Your Honor, sir. You got no idea how many men bit the dust before I got to him. There was Baxter Red, DeGale, and Shadow, and even Whistle Jenkins, Sheriff Poker Falls, named just a few.
Good, good. So many less no-goods running around.
Yeah. You're absolutely right, Your Honor, sir. So many less no-goods running around.
I'll give you $10,000 right away.
$310,000. And add some 6% interest to be exact. I should think the director of any bank would jump so as to be first to make amends.
Well said.
So jump.
Now, Your Honor, sir, why don't you write a little letter to the judge?
What should I write?
Dear Judge, unfortunately, I spent all of the money.
And if I refuse to?
I'll spend it.
You'll get a bullet, whereas this way you'll just end up with a few years in jail.
Now then, where were we? Oh, yes. Dear Judge.
Dear Judge.
Just tell it the way it was, about how you got the idea of teaming with Jenkins, about him being the brains and you being the muscle. Sure, a job like that would never succeed unless it was organized from the inside.
Right.
Yeah, pretty well figured. Poor old Jenkins. Boy, I have to admit that that part wasn't easy. But you don't want to write that.
But you're right that Sartana is a modest, honest gentleman. Because he never did no crime. Now, right. Hey, if you're such a damn gentleman, how come you walked off with that $300,000?
Come on, buddy. Gentleman Sartana can do no wrong. And besides, that money was already stolen.